Hello and yes, welcome to another video with RockBoy680. That's me. Today I'm going over all of my John Lennon vinyls. I'm going to be going over my 45 singles and my 12-inch albums, and I've got a couple of 12-inch singles in here as well. I said I'd be doing a video like this again because I've already done one on Elton John and one on Paul McCartney. So, you know, you all knew it was coming. So first of all, I'm going to go over my singles. I think I have a good 15 to 20 here, I think, roughly, just looking at them. I can't even remember half of them because I pick so many singles up now so easily. It's hard to keep track of all of them, to be honest. So anyway, here we go. First one up is John Lennon's Instant Karma. And then on the B-side is Yoko Ono, Who Has Seen the Wind. And funny this, it says play loud on John's side and then play quiet on Yoko's side. I don't know whether that's John even trying to take the mick out of her there, but... next one up is John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band, Power to the People. And then the B-side is Yoko Ono, Open Your Box. And there's something really cool about this one. Full Apple on the A-side, Full Apple on the B-side. So that's very interesting, I think. Next one up is John Lennon. This is from one of my favourite albums from the 70s, Walls and Bridges. Number 9, Dream. And the B-side is also a very good song because you usually get Yoko on the B-side. And no offence, because I know there are a big amount of Beatles fans who do respect and enjoy Yoko's music. I personally don't, so this is a better single for me. Really good Lennon song on the B-side, What You've Got. I really like that song. Next one up, this is my dad's old single, which he bought when John Lennon was assassinated in 1980. Imagine, and then the B-side, Working Class Hero. Two of John's best songs right there. Very good single. This is an American one. This is an American copy of that. John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band, Imagine. Except we've got It's So Hard on the B-side, and I actually really like that song as well. This is a really cool single as well, another American copy, John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band, Happy Christmas, War Is Over. And then the B-side is Yoko Ono, Listen to the Snow, Listen the Snow is Falling. And then this single, Screen, green vinyl. Pretty cool. Still looking to get a nice British copy of this in the original sleeve. I'll get it eventually. Next one in the original Apple sleeve, John Lennon's version of Ben King's master song, fantastic song, Stand By Me. But John done a really good version here, I think. And then the B-side is a Lennon song, Move Over Miss L. The single that came out just before John died. I think it was just before, or it was just after. But of course, it went straight to number one because of his assassination. Just like Starting Over. And then the B-side is Kiss, Kiss, Kiss. And then this is on his own record label. And then I have another copy of that because I've bought quite a few Beatles job lot singles, and you know, such a popular single, you always get this. I had another copy. I had three copies at one point, but I actually managed to sell one of them on. Next one up, John Lennon, Woman. And B-side is Yoko Ono, Beautiful Boys. And another one of John Lennon, Woman. And B-side is Yoko Ono, Walking on Thin Ice. And this one is a clear vinyl. It's got written on the side, for jukeboxes only. Nobody told me. And a sanity, Yoko Ono. John Lennon, 28th of November 1974, which was when he played live with Elton John. And I believe backstage was when he got back together with Yoko. and it's on the DJM Records, which is what Elton John was on. And then I have another copy of it. And I believe this is a German record. Not sure there. Made in Germany, yeah. Last one, John isn't actually singing on this. This is, you know, I picked this up for 10p. Yoko Ono, Walking on Thin Ice for John. I do really like the cover of this single, though. You know, it comes out with this cut out bit of cardboard, the lyrics on. And then there's the record. Okay, now moving on to the album. So first one up is my Japan copy of Unfinished Music number 2, Life with the Lions. This is John and Yoko. Generally, this is just a collector's item, in my opinion. The music on it, I don't listen to it. I can't imagine why people would. You know, I'm sorry to fans of these weird, wacky albums, but, you know, it's not worth listening to. John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band live piece in Toronto, 1969. The Plastic Ono Band here is made up of John Lennon, Yoko Ono, Eric Clapton, Klaus Voormann, and Alan White. So Eric Clapton and Klaus Voormann, they're also very well-known artists. John's first studio solo album. This is the Plastic Ono Band album. This is a fantastic record. This record here, pretty much John just had, you know, a load of anger in him. He wasn't in the best place at this point in time, and he just lets it all out on this record. Fantastic album. This is my original first pressing British. The original sleeve. And then I have another copy, which I got for free. And then this was the first copy of it, which I bought. Which I generally don't need anymore, so, you know, I might sell this one on. This is my copy, which was made in France. Next up, his number one album, Imagine. Great album, a lot of people's favourites. This is my complete original. Doesn't have the postcard or the poster, though, but this one does. But this is a later copy, I think. From 72, I'm guessing. Sometime in New York City, you know, John's weakest album, definitely. I mean, he only gets about 3 songs on the album. The rest of the record is mainly Yoko. So, you know, to fans of the Beatles like me, who are not fans of Yoko, you know, not the best record. John Lennon, Mind Games. Fantastic album, really. This has grown on me a lot recently. I've never been huge on listening to it. But recently I've just been playing it again and again and again, and I've been loving it more and more. It's a fantastic album. John Lennon, Walls and Bridges. Another fantastic album. Again, some people's favourites. Really good record. Really enjoyable. And John's take on all the good old rock and roll songs. Generally, really good. A lot better than what Paul done. You know, I like McCartney a lot, but I always felt that his Russian album was a bit, you know, rushed. And the Run Devil Run album, I don't know, I've just never been a huge fan of that album. But, you know, John's rock and roll album, fantastic. That's my Apple copy. And then I have a MFP copy here. Different back covers. John Lennon's Shaved Fish. This was his greatest hits album, which came out just when he retired. Just after he retired, should I say. And then, of course, the last record which he put out. Fantastic album. Double Fantasy. Even some of Yoko's stuff on here isn't that bad, in all honesty, you know. Because I actually put the record on the other night, and I listened to Yoko's stuff as well. A couple of her songs are not even that bad, you know. The John stuff, everything that John done on this album is unbelievable. And then I have another copy here, which I got in another job lot. the John Lennon collection. Some really good tracks on here. Milk and Honey. This was the one that came out in 84. After his death, obviously, you know. But, you know, even though a lot of the tracks on here weren't completely finished, they still sounded really good. Then I have the 12-inch single here from the album, Borrowed Time. Which is really cool. Mind you, though, when I got this, it was so dirty and so, you know, messed up. I've cleaned it and it looks nearly brand new, this record, actually. Jealous Guy, and on the B-side, Going Down on Love and Oyo Ko. John Lennon Live in New York City. And The Last Word. And this is a limited edition picture vinyl. We've got John there, John and Yoko there. Then last one, I only got this yesterday. I just showed it in my vinyl update video, which I shot yesterday. The 40th anniversary Imagine box set, which is really cool. You know, I'm most likely going to be doing a video just on this, so I won't show you everything that's in there at the minute. So there you go, there's all my John Lennon vinyls. Not including Beatles stuff, obviously. Next person I'll most probably be doing, or band, where I'll be showing all my records of theirs, will most likely be either Electric Light Orchestra, because I've got quite a few of theirs now. Possibly my George Harrison stuff. You know, I've already done a video on my Beatles stuff, you know, several times. But, you know, I've got a lot since I last done them, so I might do another Beatles vinyl video, you know, or somebody else like that. But at the minute, you know, there we go. There's my John Lennon records. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and leave a message. Thanks for watching.